Thank you. Hi everyone, I'm Rachel here from Bride Life, and I'm here with Tyler Peck, principal dancer for New York City Ballet, and Justin Warshaw, the CEO and creative director of Justin Alexander. I'm here to talk to them today about their beautiful new collaboration and give you a little behind the scenes chat with them. Justin, how did this project come to be?
So as our bridal markets have turned digital, we decided to accompany our launches with fulfilling projects that are true to our core values. Last season, we partnered with Vow to End Child Marriage. Princess Mabel of Aranya inspired our customers with her mission and struggles of child brides around the world. So she really educated them on the big issue that is plaguing child brides and child marriages. And we raised some donations and made a large donation ourselves to accompany our launch. Now, this year, we wanted to do something different, but we still wanted to stay true to our core values and also inspire brides and retailers around the world. So we had a big brainstorm session and we thought about partnering with a local business or local company. And we had this idea to create a project that was like a piece of artwork that can inspire brides around the world. And we thought to partner with New York City Ballet, but it's currently shut down and there are no performances at this moment. So I actually reached out to my uncle, who happens to be a friend of once principal dancer at New York City Ballet, Heather Watts, and just to talk about the project and see if there was any synergies there, if she knew of anyone that could be of interest for us to partner with. And she immediately thought of Tyler Peck as someone that might be able to execute this this project for us. So that's kind of how it came to be. We really wanted to do something that transported our retailers to New York, because New York bridal market is normally taking place in April and October. So that's one of the big reasons why we wanted to partner with a local New York business or performance company.
Tyler, what did you think about the project when it was first presented to you?
So when Heather Watts very first called me to tell me about the project, she said, you know, I have this friend, Justin, who would love to kind of mix dance with the collection. And how would you feel about making a wedding video? And I thought, well, I'm not getting married, so is that going to be a little strange? But then we started talking about it and I thought, oh, this is the perfect opportunity to, you know, kind of challenge myself. And not only will I be dancing, but I'll have to use my acting skills and, you know, be directing and think of the vision and how are we going to interweave all these feelings into one video. So I thought this is going to be a really great partnership. It's going to be a really wonderful collaboration between Justin Alexander and myself. And I just sort of looked at it as that way, as like a really great kind of piece of art that we were going to create together.
It's kind of like planning a wedding, but all in one.
Yeah, I was like getting married. Literally, I had my sister's wedding on our shoot day, like what she's doing.
You only had about a month to execute everything. So it's like the ultimate, you know?
It was crazy. Yeah.
Justin, why did you feel like it was important to tell this story?
We wanted to create something that brides could relate to. You know, right now it's so difficult. You know, you yourself, Rachel, you're an engaged bride, but everyone knows somebody that's going through this right now. You know, the struggles of wedding cancellation, postponement, you know, those ups and downs. There are also so many COVID couples and COVID engagements now. So we wanted to tell this story. Bring hope, and also because, you know, ultimately love always wins. And we wanted to create something that was entertaining and fulfilling at the same time.
Justin, do you happen to be one of those COVID engagements right now?
Yeah, actually, I am a COVID engagement. You know, I met my fiance prior to COVID, but it really brought us closer, you know, living together through, you know, the ups and downs of COVID. And ironically, I was proposing to my fiance while Tyler was filming this performance. So it's kind of quite timely for me.
Serendipitous, yeah. Tyler, with your sister being a COVID-19 bride and getting married, how did that affect your preparation for this performance? And how did you weave the emotions of a COVID-19 bride into this performance?
I think the fact that she is going to be getting married during the pandemic really made me able to relate to the project, because I see, you know, what she's going through, constantly having to rechange plans, rechange dates, how many people are going to be there? Are there going to be people there? And so, you know, it's difficult. I feel like having a wedding and planning one in general is always hard. But I think during these kind of circumstances, I really feel for the brides. But at the end of the day, what my sister keeps saying is like, you know, at least I found my person. And I think that that's kind of what Justin referred to earlier. It's that, you know, really it's about the marriage between the two individuals, and having family and friends is kind of like the bonus. So that's what I kind of tried to weave into the choreography, those feelings of excitement, sadness, like uncertainty, and just kind of the ups and downs that are happening right now.
Tyler, how did you create the choreography for this performance?
I think the first thing for me for choreography is always the music. So we had to wait until Justin and I kind of settled on the music. And then as soon as that happened, I got into my mother's dance studio and I just sort of started playing around with movements. I didn't have my partner yet, so it's really hard to choreograph a pas de deux when you don't have a partner yet. So it was just kind of like an idea. And then once he was quarantined and tested and we were finally able to get together, I said to him, you know, like, okay, this is like the framework, but I didn't have your hands, so I'm not sure if the arms actually work. So let's just go with it. And as we started picking different locations, the choreography had to change a little bit. So even the day of when we were in those different locations, we had to sort of change things around a bit, because like the stairs were a little longer and we hadn't been practicing on stairs. Or once we got in the backyard, we had to wait for, you know, the filmographers to kind of say, okay, we want to do this section here and this section there. So then we tailor made it for that specific location.
Justin, do you think weddings post COVID-19 will look the same as weddings pre COVID-19?
What will look different is definitely, you know, the weddings during COVID, because, you know, obviously right now brides and couples have so many restrictions on how they can wed. So there are a lot of, you know, micromonies and, you know, elopements taking place. But the celebrations post, I mean, since the beginning of this pandemic, we've kind of known that towards the end and when we can finally safely celebrate together, that I think we're going to have some amazing grand weddings where family and friends will gather and really celebrate the union of two people, two families. And so I think ultimately the wedding industry is always evolving and, you know, trends change. But I think, in fact, I really believe strongly that, you know, we're going to want to celebrate coming out of this. I know for sure there will be a lot more Sunday weddings, because I know, Rachel, you're one of those Sunday weddings, because I'll be attending yours. So yeah, I think they're going to look a lot like weddings prior. But as I said, trends change in bridal industry. And I think destination weddings are going to be really big, because I believe we want to travel so badly. And so if, you know, if you had a wedding planned or a wedding in mind, what better way to kind of get, you know, two things out of the way? Let's go to this amazing destination we've been wanting to go to, go with family and, you know, celebrate our love for one another. So I can see that be a bigger trend moving forward for sure as well.
It's so interesting, because that's kind of like another natural partnership or something in common between the bridal world and the performance world. Like, it, you know, when it comes back, it's all going to come back.
Yeah, absolutely. We look forward to that too.
Tyler, what was your favorite part about creating this dance? And did you have a favorite outfit?
Yes. My favorite part about creating the dance was that the music we chose and the feelings that we had to kind of, you know, relay in a 6 or 7 minute video, it kind of made it feel like very fulfilling, because I got to go on the whole ride. And for me, definitely the dress that I chose to get married in was obviously my favorite. I was like, I want to wear that one. And I think it's the back is just so stunning.
I remember the dress. It's got like a bikini neckline and a keyhole back. And you wore a beautiful, dramatic cathedral length veil, I think, walking down the aisle. That was stunning.
Yeah. So that was definitely my favorite dress. It kind of just fit perfectly. And I felt like I was getting married. But yeah, for me, it was just getting to do the different types of dances. So when we were in City Hall, it was very uppity and we were excited, you know, and then the music kind of dropped. And then we're outside in this beautiful backyard to dance, you know, for like the reception, kind of our forever dance, our first dance. It's going to last forever. And it was just so fun to be dancing in these beautiful gowns too. And dance, I think, shows them off even more than you would normally see, right? Because you don't normally see a bride really kicking her leg or being lifted. So for me, I thought that the dance also just kind of showcased the beautiful like fabric and material of the gowns.
And Tyler, I have to admit, when I watched the trailer for the first time, I had a hard time looking at the dresses, because you and Roman are absolutely unbelievable at what you do. At the same time, I was like, why have we not thought to do this before? Because it's so amazing to show a collection through dance. So thank you for that and for giving us this opportunity.
Oh, it was my pleasure. We had so much fun making it.
So Tyler, I want to thank you so much for your cooperation and partnership and collaboration on this project. You know, I'm so impressed with how you work, how you operate, and, you know, your dance is so inspiring. And I really think brides and retailers will love the way you've told their story and kind of the empathy that you've shown in how, you know, you've taken what they're going through and bringing it to life through dance is unbelievable. And, you know, I really love the piece of work we've created and, you know, I'll always cherish it. So again, thank you so much for your partnership, and hopefully we can do something again in the future.
Oh, I feel the exact same way. I immediately said, I want to do something else. Like, this feels like the perfect partnership. And, you know, for me, the main reason why I dance is because I love expressing myself through movement. And so I think that this was a great collaboration, because I am able to express the emotions that brides are feeling during now through dance. And I think that dance is this universal language that everyone can kind of understand. And so for me to just partner with a brand like Justin Alexander and be able to do what I love, dance, was just, it was a gift. So I hope that we're able to bring some sort of joy and inspiration to brides.
Well, I'll say that as a bride, I'd like to thank you, Tyler. And I would like to thank you, Justin, because it feels so exciting for people to do something special for us right now. Cause you don't want to ask for it yourself. You don't want to say like, you know, is anyone thinking about my wedding? But it just feels uplifting that there are so many people that believe in love and want each and every bride to be happy in their own way. And this is just really exciting and gives me hope for, you know, all the weddings.
Most definitely.
And thanks again, Tyler.